Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Dr. Himanshu Gupta, and today in this video we are going to discuss a very important topic for NEET PG, that is immunohemolytic anemia. It is also known as autoimmune hemolytic anemia. The term immunohemolytic anemia is preferred because it is not only due to its body's own cells, but it can also occur due to drug reactions. Okay, so that is why we prefer the term immunohemolytic anemia. So as the name suggests, it is caused by antibodies that bind to RBCs and cause their premature destruction. It is of two types, warm antibody type and a cold antibody type. So the question that is asked is, the most common hemolytic anemia is immunohemolytic anemia is warm antibody type. The antibodies that are here are IgG class antibodies. Okay, so if you have to remember, the mnemonic is warm weather is good. So you can remember this mnemonic and you will never confuse between what type of antibodies are produced in this type of anemia. Okay, now what happens in immunohemolytic anemia? Antibodies react with RBCs at an optimum temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. So IgG coated RBCs bind to Fc receptors of phagocytes, and these phagocytes cause partial phagocytosis by removing RBC membrane. Okay, so when they remove the RBC membrane, they turn to spherocytes. You can see spherocytes are formed in autoimmune hemolytic anemia. So when the spherocytes are formed, these are sequestered and destroyed in spleen. Resulting in extravascular hemolysis. Okay, so RBCs are destroyed in the spleen, and also because of the extravascular hemolysis, you will see splenomegaly in these patients. Okay, now you have to remember the causes of warm antibody type immunohemolytic anemia. 50% cases are idiopathic. Okay, it can associated with other autoimmune disorders like SLE, rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, lymphoid neoplasms like chronic lymphocytic leukemia, drug hypersensitivity. So drug hypersensitivity can be due to two types. One is antigenic drugs and other are tolerance breaking drugs. So friends, you have to remember that tolerance breaking drugs are alpha methyl dopa, whereas drug hypersensitivity reactions occur in penicillin, cephalosporin and quinidine. So this is a direct question that can come in your exam. Okay, so what do you understand by antigenic drugs? Antigenic drugs are those drugs which bind to RBC membrane and form a complex with the RBC membrane, and then antibodies are formed against this complex. Antibodies are formed against the complex of RBC membrane plus drug. Okay, in alpha methyl dopa, the mechanism is unknown, but what happens is that antibodies are produced against the intrinsic antigens of the RBCs. Antigens are produced against the intrinsic antigens of the RBCs. Okay, now cold immunohemolytic anemia. So it is further of two types, cold agglutinin type and cold hemolysin type. Cold agglutinin type, it is caused by IgM antibodies. It is seen in patients recovering from infections like mycoplasma, EBV, HIV. You can remember that cold ice cream is yummy. Okay, so this will help you in remembering IgM antibodies and mycoplasma infection. Remember that it is a self-limiting disease and there is not much destruction of RBCs. Okay, So what happens is that when these antibodies bind to RBCs in vascular beds cooler than 30 degrees Celsius, such as in ears, nose and toes. Okay, so basically clinical symptoms occur when RBCs when antibodies bind to RBCs in vascular beds cooler than 30 degrees Celsius. When these RBCs bind to antibodies, recirculates and it gets forms, these antibodies are released from the RBC membrane before the complement mediated hemolysis can occur. Okay, so that is why it is a self-limiting disease. So when the blood circulates in the vascular beds cooler than 30 degrees Celsius, like ear, nose and toes, these antibodies bind to RBCs. But when they again reach the central circulation, the blood gets warm, these antibodies are released. Okay, so that is why it is a self-limiting disease. Cold hemolysin type occurs in paroxysmal cold hemoglobinuria. IgG antibodies bind to P antigen on RBCs. Remember, antibodies bind to P antigen on RBCs, and these antibodies are known as Donath-Lantsteiner antibodies. Okay, so these antibodies result in intravascular hemolysis and hemoglobinuria. This you have to remember. This is because these antibodies cause complement mediated destruction of RBCs, and these are associated with viral infections and most commonly occurs in children. So diagnosis is by a direct comb test. So thank you friends for watching this video. Do like my video and all the best for your preparation.